I'm deeply grateful today to the Almighty God for enabling us to see this day and this season, and especially for preserving the life of Mr. President and myself through the past 4 years and giving us a second opportunity to steer the affairs of our nation. Glory be to his name forevermore. I'm also thankful for all of us who are here, many who were here 4 years ago at about the same time, and who are here today. Thank the Almighty God that you're also able to see this day. My short message is that the future is bright. The future is bright. The Bible says that the path of the just has a special place. The path of the just shall shine brighter and brighter every day unto that perfect day. The same Bible also says that the glory of the latter house shall be greater than the glory of the former. Everything that Scripture tells us reminds us that because of the love of the Almighty God, especially for those of us of the faith, our days will be better and better, brighter and brighter. This is the reason why I am so confident and why the Bible urges us to be confident. For the special reason why we of faith must be confident is because the Scripture says concerning us again that we are the light of the world. We are the light of the world. Where there is darkness and pain, we bring succor and hope. Our ministry is a ministry of reconciliation, first with God through Christ, then with our fellow men and women, with Muslims, with Hindus, and even with those who deny the existence of God. Secondly, we are the salt of the earth. The Scripture reminds us that salt has a special quality, the quality of ensuring that things do not go wrong. By our words and action, we heal, even as salt heals and prevents rottenness. St. Paul reminds us, and reminded the Christians in Colossae, of the power that their words have, and that their words have the power to heal or to destroy, depending on how they spoke and what they said. And I'd like to remind us also of the same, those of us of the faith, in Colossians 4:6, the Scripture says, let your speech always be with grace, seasoned with salt, that you may know how you ought to answer each one. We must not, as Cardinal Onoyeko reminded us today, permit anyone to take advantage of the fault lines of tribe and religion in our country. Again, the Word of God has set a standard for us, first as Christians, and then how to build beyond our Christianity. In Galatians 3:28, the Scripture says that there is neither Jew nor Greek, there is neither slave nor free, there is neither male nor female, for you are all one in Christ Jesus. We are all one in Christ Jesus. Our country stands today at the threshold of phenomenal greatness. If we look back or permit fear or despair, we will stumble. So we must move forward in faith and confidence that Christ has given us. Let me show you the word of God concerning our nation. In Genesis 1:1-4, the Scripture says that in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. It says that the earth was without form and void, and that darkness was upon the face of the deep. But even while darkness was upon the face of the deep, the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the water. Then God said, let there be light. And there was light. And God saw that it was good. And God divided the light from the darkness. Just as it was at the beginning of creation, darkness was only the beginning of the story. The end of the story was light and joy, and so it is with our nation, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. We may begin with darkness, we may begin with confusion, as it was at creation. But the end of our story is light. The end of our story is good. The end of the story of this nation shall be great indeed, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Finally, we are men and women of faith, and we must continue to express the hope that we have been given by Christ Jesus. We must continue to express that hope, and we must lead our nation with a full expectation of the hope that we have been given and the hope that we have. We cannot afford to despair. We who are men and women of faith must not even speak words that sound like despair. It is our duty to show the way. Just as the word of God says in 1 Corinthians 15, verse 58. 1 Corinthians 15, verse 58. It says, therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that your labor will not be in vain. Our labor will not be in vain. We must be steadfast and we must be movable. We must be confident in all of the promises that God has made concerning our nation. The future of our nation is bright. Your future and the future of generations to come is very bright indeed. God bless our nation. God bless you all. Thank you.